What's up everyone, Takedown here. Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be sharing with you a little bit of my hockey collection. This is going to be my collectibles outside of my hockey cards, which I do on this channel. This is going to be things like figures, autographs, and pucks, things of that nature. Let's get right into this. So the first thing I'm going to be sharing with you, as you guys might know, I'm a huge fan of Connor McDavid. So last year I went and purchased his Funko Pop. I've always been a fan of the Funko Pop, except I just don't have enough money to go and purchase a whole bunch of these. So for my first Funko Pop, I decided to go with Connor McDavid because I'm such a huge fan of his. Maybe in the future I will get some more Funko Pop, but this is the first one and I decided to go with Connor McDavid just so I can spruce up my hockey collectibles in a way, if that makes any sense. The next item that I have, keeping along the theme of Connor McDavid, is a figure of Connor McDavid. Now, the funny story of this one is I actually got this with NHL 18. It was a bundle for Walmart. I think it's a Walmart exclusive, but I got this on Black Friday. Now, the flyer said the game and bundle for $49.99. When I got there that day, the employee that was getting it out of the display case said it was only the game for $49.99, but the flyer did specify that it was game and figure. So she had to basically go and overwrite it and give me the game and figure bundle. So that's how I got this figure. So I'm a huge fan of Connor McDavid. The fact that I got it and the game for $49.99, I'm a huge fan of it. I loved the game. So to have a figure, something else to add to my hockey collection, I was a huge fan of, and I did love it, especially since I got it for the price and it included the video game. The next item I'm going to be sharing is an autograph, and it is for a favorite of mine, which is Mark Stone. So the story behind this is back, I think Ottawa Senators still do this, but their arena is the Canadian Tire Center, and I used to work at Canadian Tire. So Canadian Tire, since they sponsor the arena, the Ottawa Senators went around, I think they still do, they go around to a whole bunch of different Canadian Tires that are local to the area. Mine is about an hour away from Ottawa, the closest one, which is where I live, and they actually showed up one year to my store. So usually they only bring one prospect and one player, so Mark Stone actually was coming to my town. So I decided to go, and since it was my off day, I went, purchased this picture. I had to get the frame separately, but I actually got him to sign it in person. So this has a great story behind it, and I'm a fan of the Ottawa Senators, so this is my first autograph in my collection. So personally, I'm happy to have that. The next item I'm going to be sharing with you is my first bobblehead that I've got, and it's the only one in my collection, and it is for Mark Lemieux. Now this is for back whenever he was part of Team Canada and won the gold medal at the Olympics. The cool story behind this one is my dad actually got this for $2 at a yard sale, and he gave it to me for my birthday last year, which even though he told me how much he paid for it, the fact that he found something so unique and so iconic for me, because I do love collecting things and he knows I have a hockey collection, to add this to it is pretty epic because it's in the original packaging. In the original box, it's never been opened. The box is a little beat up, but nothing too major, and it is in perfect condition. I've seen some of these before that they are a little scuffed up and marked because people took them out of the box and put it on a shelf, but the fact that this has never been opened means so much to me, and the fact that my dad shared that story with me of how he got it means a lot because I've never been able to find one in that good of condition. Next item I'm going to be sharing is some more things that I got at Canadian Tire the same day that I got the Mark Stone autograph, and that is some more autographs. So like I said, not only did Mark Stone go, but also Nick Paul, because that year he was actually a prospect for the team, and also there was a surprise, which was Chris Phillips. Usually only, like I said, one player, which was Mark Stone, and one prospect go, which was Nick Paul. Chris Phillips actually announced his retirement, I think about a month prior to the event at my Canadian Tire. So he did a surprise appearance at my Canadian Tire for that event. He didn't go to any other Canadian Tires for the events, just mine. So it meant a lot to me. So not only did I get Nick Paul's signed in person, I did get the other three as well. I got Mark Stone, Chris Phillips, and another Nick Paul. Now, I did get, like I said, one Nick Paul signed in person. The other three, what happened was the players, basically each player received a stack of cards, and they went and signed about 50 of them, and then they went and handed them to the boss, and the boss handed them out to the employees. So I got one signed in person, and I received the other ones the next day when I was at work. So it was pretty special that they did that, and that my boss handed them out. And the last item in my collection, I got the same day as my autographs, and that is a hockey puck. Now, this is my most treasured item in my collection, and it is an autograph for Chris Phillips. Chris Phillips is tied, in my opinion, for my top three Ottawa Senators, along with Chris Neal and Daniel Alfredson. Of course, there's a bunch of other players that are close to that as well that are up there, but Chris Phillips is definitely one that I'm a huge fan of. To me, the only thing that I regret is not having a gold or silver marker to have him sign it. And the reason that I didn't decide to bring anything like that is because I didn't know until last minute that he was actually going to be appearing at my store. So if I had known, I would have brought in something that would have made it pop a little bit more. This is pretty epic on its own. You can see the signature, but if it was gold or silver, it would have popped a little bit more and it would have meant a lot more to me. I almost got a picture with him as well because he put his arm around me and my dad. Back then I had a fourth gen iPod, I think. My dad doesn't know how to take pictures with technology and stuff like that. So instead of taking the picture and you're hitting the button on the screen, he was hitting the home button. So it wasn't working for him. So unfortunately, I didn't get a picture with Chris Phillips, but I did get an autographed puck from him. So that is my most treasured item in my hockey collection. Like I said, I'm a huge fan of Chris Phillips, and I was so thrilled that he was going to make a special appearance that day. That's why I decided to have him sign a puck out of all the items available. So these are most of my hockey collectibles, and I decided to share them in this video because I don't think I've ever shared them all in a video before. I might have shared different ones whenever I picked them up before, but I never made a video like this. Usually I stick to about hockey cards and stuff like that for my hockey collectibles, but that's why I decided to make this video. So I hope you guys did enjoy seeing a little bit more of my hockey collection, and I hope you guys enjoyed me sharing that with you. I'm gonna leave this video here. Please take care. Peace.